Now we're going to say here, lattice energy is the enthalpy chain that occurs when one mole of ionic solid separates into its ions. Now we're going to say it tells us the strength of ionic interactions and has an influence on a lot of features. Melting point, hardness, solubility, boiling point, freezing point. And a good example of lattice energy, the formula that we use for it, a good example would just be Li plus gaseous phase with F minus gaseous phase combining to give us LiF solid. And we're going to say here, delta H would be 10 to 50 kilojoules per mole. So the lattice energy needed to break up lithium fluoride would be that much. This is how much energy would be required of us to break up lithium fluoride. Now, we're going to say here, the formula for lattice energy or ionic bond energy can be broken down as this. We're going to say it equals the cation charge times the anion charge in absolute brackets. Now, because it's absolute, we know that the anion charge will be negative, the cation charge will be positive. And a negative times a positive gives me a negative answer. But because it's in absolute brackets, the answer overall will be positive. And that's going to be divided by the cation radius plus the anion radius. What do I mean by radius? I mean period number. Now, I'm breaking down lattice energy in a much, much simpler way than your book or your professor normally would. In your book, it gives you a much complicated, larger formula in order to figure out who has the largest lattice energy. You don't really need to use that larger formula. You just need to focus on the fundamentals. And this equation just breaks off all the complex part of the equation and gives you the most important part that you need to know. When it comes to lattice energy, you can use this basic form of the equation to always get the right answer.